Okay. Well, well, well. How disappointed I feel about myself. I feel weak. And I feel useless in a way. I was one of these people who was very, very strongly against Apple. Actually, for a minute, I wanted them to kind of, like, what is it, kick the bucket and disappear? Yeah, really. I was at that point in my life where I had so much trouble. On with the review. I got this iPad Pro very recent. I didn't spend a lot of time with it. It's an 11-inch screen, of course, it's called iPad Pro 11. 12-megapixel camera, 4GB RAM, which might seem a lot of pathetic and small to a lot of laptops or performance laptops, performance machines. But you have to understand that the Apple was not never been about specs. That is until this thing came out. And of course, 7,812, which is almost roughly 8,000, you know, milliamp battery. That's massive. It will last you a long time. It will basically kill any gaming laptop by the time. This thing can last you a month if you're using it just to browse and chill. 20 days, easily. I use it for work, and it lasts me around 4 to 5 days of heavy usage. I don't game on it. I use it for my work, and it does what I want. This is using the A12 processor, A12X, which is the latest and greatest, you know, chip that Apple made for its tablets. It's really powerful. The raw power that this thing has makes it, you know, when you have enough power and the software is very limiting, it's more of like an insult to the machine. So right now, I've never seen a machine that has been insulted more than this machine, because it's got so much power, and a lot of people complain the lack of software. And this is where I have a problem with. Now, with the update of the iPad OS, you don't have to worry about that anymore. You know, Apple have finally learned the lesson, set their, you know, started playing their cards right, and set their creative direction very, very straight in a path that I would like. So I can sit down and talk about what it does and what it doesn't do. You know, split screen and all what and all that and these things. You know, you can do a lot of, you know. So it's got Face ID. There's no longer a fingerprint sensor. I'm a little bit late for the game. This is not a review of the product, so whether you should buy it or not. This is more of my opinion about it, and why should you get it from a person who used to dislike Apple so much, and to just, you know, move on to the iPad and get this instead of a gaming laptop. A lot of people will be like, whoa, so you sold your gaming laptop for now? No, I still have my gaming laptop. I still got my gaming PC. But this does, you know, the things that I could do easily on my phone, but with a bigger screen, like writing, you know, sheets or writing scripts for my shows, or browsing the internet comfortably without having to strain your eyes over using your phone for a long time. I like that. It's very comfortable. It's like a screen that you can just like dive in and browse and at ease. The fact that there's keyboard support, mouse support, makes it very easy. So could this be what replaces your laptop? Yeah, it could. It could pretty much do that. For a casual person who wants to use it to browse, iPad will do the job. For someone who wants to also create professional grade content or any media type of content, you know, this will be the laptop to get. It is not cheap though. It is, you're paying so much for its price. And unfortunately, as of yet, the iPad OS is in its infancy. And there are so many things that it's lacking. The mouse support is great, but it's not perfect. The keyboard support has been there for quite a while. It works, and it works well. But it could still use some improvements. But that's, I guess, something that you should take on with the manufacturer of your third-party keyboard. I don't use the Apple keyboard. It's very small. It's not backlit, and it just doesn't feel as great as this one. So I stick to what works. This gives it this very Mac, MacBook feel, you know, so I love that. It's great. It has a bit of weight to it, but it's great. It's way lighter than my gaming laptop, and I love it. So yeah, that's basically what I have to say about it. Besides the fact that the software will continue to improve over time and things will get better. This can't replace your phone, but it can replace your laptop when it comes to browsing and just accessing the Apple's massive line of products, applications on the App Store. Then the problem is, well, with the accessories, the pen and all that, I know you have to buy all these things extra, and I don't know what you're paying, almost $1,000 for, you know, but Apple is Apple. It has a fast charger that comes in with the box, so thank God. And the USB Type-C doesn't work with anything besides its own charger. It has this Apple thing, even so, there's a USB Type-C. You still need to use the charger in the box. And I think at this point, you just might as well use it because it prolongs the longevity of your battery. So that's pretty much it. I know it was a very general, very broad, but I just wanted to talk about my experience with this thing. It's more of my opinion about it, my review. For more detailed reviews, you can find plenty of them on YouTube, you know. So that's it, guys. Like the video if you like it. If you don't, you know what to do. Subscribe for more. I'll see you guys in the next video.